Mungano really grew out of, it started in Nairobi, but it started especially through the model of savings. It went to other counties in Mombasa, Kisumu, Nakuru, and many other areas they have grown. So they still have Mungano chapters there. So Mungano Trust really initially started, really was supportive of the growth of Mungano. In my view, Mungano has changed because we started as a movement that was focusing on anti-eviction. There have been changes of leadership also. The Mungano was somehow split in the sense that some section of Mungano would form another network, like Ngazi ya Chini, which specialized in fighting, going back to the original evictions, resisting evictions. They have been very active, for example, in Kibera. They work specifically with an NGO, Amnesty International. There is also this other one that he calls itself Nairobi People's Movement. It's also part of Mungano, but they worked mostly, they started working with Haki Jamii. So you can see Mungano has been split into other movements with the same leadership, but working now with different partners. So some sort of competition arose among the NGOs and among the leadership of Mungano. You can see each NGO is working with a particular section of Mungano, and they are pushing the agenda. But they are all working for urban poor, you know? And that can so that has prevented the force, you know, the initial force of Mungano talking as a big movement of urban poor has been watered down. And I think that's a challenge. Maybe it's for us as partners to come together and see what is the best, how do we work best in achieving all these things, so that we don't split the communities and we remain strong. The other challenges for Mungano is, I think, internal democracy among themselves. Usually sometimes they don't have a good mechanism for elections, for running as an organization. And you find the same leaders all the time. You know? That's a big challenge. We need to strengthen, I think, the organizational capacity, how they are internally organized to change leadership and so on. When there is money, when there is savings, usually leaders sometimes focus on the money side.